features that has been provided which give value, market value, then how do you calculate, which means the prioritization of the features, which feature should go first to the market, you know, whether our competitor is going first or we have to go first, those kind of things will go into the feature driven development. End up in stage two, two questions I can take, and then I can go to stage three. The last, when I say here, it is not stopping, these, all these activities will go on. Automated monitoring, so this I think Manisha mentioned. Monitoring of the activities, yes, there are some automations are there from the ops perspective. They may be having GNOG, they may be having, you know, local service now. So these automations are well within the perspective of the ops perspective. How it is getting connected to the dev side. Okay. Whether the person, if there is any kind of site issues or any kind of deployment issue, that feedback, whether it is getting moved or not. Not only feedback, even we have made in such a way that SMS, when there is a site issue, it could be a site accident or network issue, and how it is getting automated so that the respective person getting the feedback in terms of SMS feedback or, you know, kind of SMS alert kind of thing. So those kind of automation, this area we have not done. We are going to, so let me be very frank on this one. This is the area which we are going for. Quite in another way, we already have systems. You can see in Huawei COLO, in YouTube you can find Huawei Colo project. It's a project between Huawei and Intel. So that we are, you know, also focusing on these areas.
So, since you are not doing automated deployment on a regular basis?
Both. And this production stack is somehow cut off. Feature toggling is also we are planning. Right now it is manually configured in the configuration file as of now. But we also want to manage the feature because we it is slightly tied up with a single track. Because our product scenario is such a way where we have, you know, several customers using, so which means there is a lot of customization. You know, one particular set of product gets customized for different market, different customers like that. But problem comes is you have to do the testing of all the branches, which becomes very difficult. So what we are making is coming up with a single track, which means a common set, all the features in one, and just you toggle the features based on the switch. Which means if our product is getting used in Airtel, and if they have, you know, subscribed for five features, only that is toggled. Others are switched off. But this requires a complete engineering discipline. It's not just a simple configuration. From the design itself, you have to take care. That is this program single track. Another way, you can call Ericsson's one track. If you go to Ericsson's one track, you can learn about, very detail about what is this single track is all about. Automated production deployment, more or less here. So okay, deployments, and then even the advanced level here, we just spoke about the staging environment, then it's going about the production environment. This and this are slightly cut off. Automation production environment and structured logging. Structured logging is, this is a discipline, it is not automation. Every developer from developer perspective, when they are writing a logs, how they should write the log, which can be understandable from all the stakeholders, not only the development team, even the ops. Sometimes we say log, okay, error, like that. But, you know, we can't understand when somebody is testing onto the live environment, they cannot understand and learn about the log. So we have made a program of structured logging, what scenarios, what kind of text should be there, what kind of logging should be there, and is there any unification on that, that also we are taking. Automated rollback also we are planning, which means this happens when you are moving from a staged environment to the live environment. If something goes wrong, how do we automate? This anyway will be there. It's not that, you know, no organizations not having this automated rollback. That area also we are figuring out, okay, if this deployment is having some problem for some time, automatically roll back to the previous. Currently what's happening, the guys, ops guy goes there and check and then see if it's not working, manually he rolls back. That area also we are automating. But this is very tricky and very difficult because live environment we can't play. But we are trying. Anything I missed out? Yeah, I think these are a couple of blocks that
internet industry like Karina, we can impact our own platform. We call it as deployment friendly engineering. How do you, you mentioned about working together, so we kind of ask for that to be exhibited at the product code level. And one interesting thing which is kind of emerging, not as far as I kind of we chat around it as well, is we have seen architectural pattern evolve, we have seen design patterns evolve.
Yes.
So there is a deployment friendly coding patterns that seem to be our. That is something that maybe you can fit into that DFX. You know, how do you standardize coding patterns so that you achieve that DFX? That's one. Second is on the feature toggling. We call it the flag creep.
Flag, yeah.
So if you don't clean up on a regular basis, adding flags is fine with the discipline people.
You're adding the configuration file or you're what?
Yeah, the configuration, right? But it takes more discipline to clean up the flag after the bytes. So that's another point.
That connected with in the same way of how we develop. So
okay.
Yeah, your point.
So, thank you, sir, for sharing your experience on this topic. Later, we watch. So, next session will be by Shweta Sivaram.